Kitchen. As you can see, we've got decorations behind from Nell and Phoebe and some other children on the street. I wanted to do this little concert. One, because people kept asking, and two, because I really wanted to try and give something back if I could and do something. I'm sure everybody feels the same. Everybody feels a little bit helpless. And they really don't know what to do, and for me, it's what I love to do. I was meant to be doing a lot of work during these times, which I'm sure everybody else was as well, and I'm not doing it. So for me, this was my way of giving back. I've had loads of requests. I probably shouldn't have said send your requests in. I've had some crazy ones. I'm really sorry for whoever requested Metallica, but I really don't know any Metallica. I don't think I really suit it. obviously, it's a little bit different. Normally, I've got an orchestra and, or even somebody doing the sound, but I'm doing the sound today, so please bear with me because I'm a little bit of a technophobe. I've got all sorts going on here. I've tried to do as many requests as I possibly could. So I really, really hope you enjoy this next song. This next song's a really special song. It's my mum's favourite song, of course, one of her requests. I want to dedicate this song to all the parents out there that have got children working in the front, on the front line, key workers, but also for the parents at home, like me, who are trying their best to bring up the kids and homeschool the kids. Again, I use that term very loosely. I'm definitely not homeschooling, I'm just doing my best. There's a lot of jobs going on and you can only do your best. And I think we just need to really take that pressure off. So this next song that I'm going to sing for you is You Raise Me Up. So bear with me.
You're wonderful, Ethel. Oh, Phoebe, they're looking for you. Hi, Neil.
You. more than I can be. Hi, thank you. Oh, I'm glad you love it. Oh, thanks, Sue, Ian, Carol, crying as usual. Oh, bless you. So, the next song that I'm going to sing for you is, again, was hugely requested. I really have gone off most of the requests and tailored them a little bit to what you've asked for. I've sung this song at major sporting events recently for the cricket at Trent Bridge. Anyone watching from there, hi. I can't wait to get back there once everything's back to normal. I've had, again, loads of requests for this. I just sang this for the wonderful Rob Burrows for his testimonial game with JJB. Sending all my love, Rob. I've seen your tweets recently about not being on the most vulnerable list with motor neurons disease, and I totally agree with you that it should be. Please keep yourself safe and your beautiful family, and we're all thinking about you and anybody else suffering with that horrific, horrific disease. Again, I sung this at the Great Yorkshire Show. That's been cancelled as well. Woo! A wonderful show. I'll be back with a vengeance next year. I know it will. I'm so proud to be part of that show. And I hope to be there next year, singing again for everybody. And above all, this is my Auntie Kath's favourite song. So this is for you, Auntie Kath, as well. Mwah. My own little audience going in the kitchen as well. Phoebe's desperate to get up. Oh, hi. I want to read out a couple of dedications because a lot of people sent me requests, but unfortunately I can't do everything. Diane Turner was Abby. Hi, we're at home and isolated for 12 weeks plus due to underlying conditions, and it will be our 30th wedding anniversary on the 7th of April. And it would be wonderful if you could add Get There, which I love that song. But again, I'm really sorry, I couldn't do everything. But sending you all my love for your anniversary, and please, please keep safe. Like everybody else out there, there's so many people that are vulnerable to this disease and virus, and it's scary and it's horrible, and all we can do is to stay in and stay safe and think about those people that are more vulnerable than we are, and just be sensible. There's a hot weekend coming up, I'm very aware of that, having two young kids myself, desperate to get out into the garden as much as I can, but please stay in the garden, do not go anywhere else, it's just not worth it. Ethel Phillips, lovely Ethel, send me a request. This is a really strange request, maybe not a song that you're familiar with, but at the moment I'm going through a difficult neurological diagnosis, and this song expresses the things that I can't always say to my family. Remember me. Sending you all my love, Ethel, and sending you all my strength. So this next song that I'm going to sing was a big request. One of my friends, Tracy P, I don't know if she's watching, but she's requested this one. It was famously done by myself and Phoebe on Instagram. And again, I had a lot of requests for The Star Is Born. So very different to Ness and Dorma, very, very different. But I'm going to perform for you now a song that I sang at the wonderful Yorkshire Choice Awards last year. Again, shout out to Mel and Joe at the Yorkshire Choice, who had to cancel their wonderful event. But again, it had to be done. I get a lot of vulnerable people go into that event, and you know, it just wasn't possible. But girls, you're amazing, and you dealt with it amazingly. So well done you, and this is for you, Shallow. And I don't have Bradley Cooper here, obviously, so I'm doing his bit. Always want to hear Phoebe.
Tell me something, girl. Are you happy in this modern world? Or do you need more? Is there something else you're searching for?
Shadow.
you.
Oh, hi, Neil. Oh, that's so lovely. Hi, Tracy. Hi, Luce. Sam. Oh, I love that one. It's a bit big and it's big, a bit different to Ness and Dharma, but, you know, I would, the messages I were getting and things, I was aware that there was going to be a very different audience. And also doing it at 6 o'clock, I'm hoping that the children are watching. And I wanted to send a very special message to Phoebe and Bobby's friends, especially Isla and Charlie and Erin, whose mum's texted me saying they'd be watching. So hi guys, I hope you're okay. I hope your mums are okay and not going too crazy, because it's a really scary, crazy time right now. And we're all struggling, aren't we, Phoebe?
Yeah.
Yeah. Trying to keep busy, trying to keep them happy, you know, and it's just what we've got to do, isn't it? It's just that that's what's happening. We've never been through anything like this before. Again, why I wanted to do something like this. What are we doing on a Saturday night now? Just watching telly, and I just love to be able to sing for you and give something back, and I hope you're enjoying it. Let me know your thoughts and how you're finding it. Oh, hi Estelle. Oh, bless you, Michelle. Hi, Evie. Oh, it's one of my pupils. I miss you. Can't wait to teach again. Right, so the next song I'm going to sing is a song all about thank you. I had quite a few messages about ABBA. So I don't particularly do much ABBA, but I do have one. So I thought I would do this one. Again, it's a total escape. Nice, beautiful song, performed really well by ABBA, always has been. It's stood the test of time. It's actually from the movie, so it's a little bit musical theatre as well. But again, lots of ABBA requests, so this one is Thank You for the Music. Cheers.
I'm nothing special, in fact, I'm a bit of a bore. When I tell a joke, you've probably heard it before. Goodbye, you Neil. But I have a talent, a wonderful thing, 'cause everyone listens when I start to sing. I'm so grateful and proud. All I want is to sing it out loud.
Music.
love that one. Let's do a few more dedications. For me, a lot of that song, Thank You for the Music, I sing because music is such a gift and I am never further away than when I'm singing. It just takes you away, doesn't it? It makes you forget and takes you to a happier place, which is exactly what we all need right now. The kids are starting to climb the walls next to me. So I got some lovely requests. A lot of people requesting Danny Boy, which I would have loved to have done, but there's just far too many other ones that people asked for. I might do that if I do another one. And the next song that I'm going to do was the second most requested. Kay Harrison requested this, and Nick Malkin and Martin Shaw said he would love to hear me sing, and all the best. Oh, thank you, Martin. Claire, you put and she'd love that. Tracy Pearson, oh, Lynn Dickinson, it's Flower Scotland. We'll see. today it would have been Howard Stevenson's 47th birthday. And today would have also been a very beautiful, special angel, Phoebe Walker Radcliffe's birthday, who unfortunately we lost far too young. I'm sending all my love, Claire, today. And this next one is specially for her and for you and for anybody else that's needing it at the moment. One of my really good friends, Barry Eaton, lost his dad yesterday. So this one is also for you, Baz. We love you and we're sending you all our love and thoughts and prayers, especially for the key workers and for everybody out there that are struggling. They feel like they're alone, but trust me, you are not. Thank you to Calendar for having me on yesterday and coming to my garden to film me singing this beautiful song. And I truly, truly mean it from the heart, and it couldn't be more poignant a song to be singing right now, because you will never walk alone. You are not alone. We are in this together and we'll get through it with sheer Yorkshire grit that we've got. It's horrible. And we can only do our best. Please stay in, please stay safe, and please enjoy this next song, You'll Never Walk Alone. This is my final song. I'm sorry if some of you have just tuned in. I hope people have got caught quite a lot of it. This final song is obviously the one that's going to be requested the most. It's the one I'm most known for. It's the one I sang at Wembley and stood a few years ago now. It's just the most wonderful, thought-provoking hymn that you could possibly sing. And I want to dedicate this to all my rugby league family. If you're watching, sending you all love and strength, and I hope you're well. And I know you're missing the rugby, aren't we all? But I'm sure it'll be the first one back. If I know the rugby league, it'll be the first one back. This song is, I want you to join in, I want you to stand up, I want you to raise your glass for anybody that's struggling, anybody that's got this horrible curse that is at the minute. And I really hope you get through this, and I hope you're not on your own, and I hope you're being looked after. I'm sending, again, love and strength to Barry and Kenshaw, my Auntie Pat. I think Auntie Pat's watching, and her beautiful sister. Sending you all my love, Auntie Pat, and I hope you find some strength in this, and I hope that you keep smiling like you always do. So can you please sing, Graham, Stacey Turner, can you please sing Abide With Me? As a whole KR fan, it was the best moment at Wembley against Leeds Rhinos for us. Thank you, that means a lot. Brad, Ollie and Amy, hi. Andrew Sheffield, can you sing Abide With Me? Duressa Mullen, we lost our lovely dad on Thursday. A massive rugby league fan, he was cared for at home by the brilliant carers and the NHS nurses. Time to say goodbye or abide with me would be really, really special for Joseph Frodsham, lifelong Saints fan and rugby league fan. Christine Kidd, anything will do. Yeah, you've heard a lot. Harry Cornish, brilliant idea, although it might be a bit strange of an hour here in Queensland. So I hope you catch this after, but abide with me. Andrea Howarth, yes, please abide with me, and abide with me again, abide with me, abide with me. So how can I not? But this will be my final song, and I hope you've enjoyed it. And let me know your thoughts and things, and I might do another one, but see how it goes. Let me know what you think. Okay, abide with me. Special, and it's been special for a long time. And the other day, me and my mum walked to the main road because one of my really good friends, Julie Goodwin, sadly lost her dad this week. Very, very special, special man who'd fought long and hard, and he lost his battle this week. And we walked to the main road and we clapped his coffin, because I'm pretty sure that other people have been affected with not being able to go to funerals and be near your loved ones and your nearest and dearest.
And it was a special, special moment. And Julie popped her head out of the window. And it was just wonderful to be able to do that. So that was for Kenshaw as well, sort of sending you all my love. And also my dad lost a friend this morning, Kevin Megson. I don't know if any of his family are watching. He was a super special man and a strong one. So that was also for him. And I hope his family are listening. I'm sorry it's been a bit emotional for people. My mom is literally sat in tears in the room now. But, you know, hopefully it's brought us all together. Hopefully it's given you something to focus on and taken you away from a little bit. I'd love to do more for you, and I will do more if that's what we want. Just let me know. I'm sending you all my love, sending you all my strength. Please stay in. Please stay safe and do what the government is saying. And let's get through this together. The quicker we abide by the rules, the quicker we'll get out of this horrible, horrible disaster that is happening at the minute. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you for your lovely messages. I love you all lots. You amazing NHS nurses, my sister. You're amazing. She's off at the minute because she's had symptoms. Ruth, I love you to bits. I'm so proud of everybody I know that's working for the NHS and key workers and people that are giving everything for us. Thank you so much, and I'll see you soon. Mwah.